Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to look at a .NET class called HttpClient is going to handle the timeouts. The HttpClient class is an important class in .NET if you want to make a HTTP request to the outside. And in the current distributed world, all our applications will be making calls outside. Most of the time, our calls will be done within 30 seconds or less than that. In rare scenarios, it may take more time. So when it is taking more time, we are expecting a timeout exception so that we can handle it properly. But let us see how this HttpClient class is doing when it is encountering a timeout. This is a .NET framework application. We are creating an object of HttpClient with a timeout of 2 seconds. Then we are making a call to an URL. So this URL is a mock URL and it will be taking 10 seconds to respond. So let us run the application and see what exception we are getting. I am running the test project in the debug mode. As we can see, instead of throwing the timeout exception, it threw a task cancel exception. It has no details about the timeout. It just says task cancelled, no inner exception. Now only way we can understand is it timeout or not is by looking at the cancellation token dot IsCancellationRequested. If it is false, that means nobody requested to cancel a task. It is timed out by itself. Now let us see how it is working for .NET 6. I am opening the test code for .NET 6. The code is same. There's no difference. Here also we have HTTP client creating with the 2 seconds of timeout, then making a web request to the same URL. Let us see how it goes. We are expecting normally timeout exception, but here also we are not getting timeout exception. Instead, we are getting the task cancelled, but this time it is better. So it says task cancelled, but the message says the request was cancelled due to the configured HTTP client dot timeout of 2 seconds elapsing. And more interestingly, if you look at the inner exception, it is a timeout exception. You can see here we can clearly understand it's a timeout exception, then we can do the things accordingly. This behavior change is there in .NET Core 3.1 onwards. I'll be adding the link to that change that happened into .NET runtime. If we are making this call ourselves, we know that we are using this class and we can easily understand when the task cancel exception throws. But what if we are using some other SDK and that SDK is internally using the HTTP client? So in that case, we don't see anything in the call stack. It just throws a task cancel exception. This can easily happen when we are working with a SharePoint, Graph SDK, or any other SDK which is using HTTP client. And most of the SDKs are using HTTP client, in fact, because HTTP client is the latest API for making a web request. If you are in such a situation, we have to intercept the creation of HTTP client in that SDK to understand whether the task cancelled is really caused by a cancelled task or due to a timeout. Hope this is useful when you are encountering these kind of situations. In case of any queries, please add into the comment section. As always, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.